You are listening to Beyond Imagination, devotional for those with mental illness. Written by Jennifer Striegle. Published by Westbow Press. Narrated by Marie Andrascik. To the man who always tucked me into bed after each terrible episode. When I say episode, I speak of a time when I got out of control due to my mental illness. The man is Craig, my second husband. He had to endure a huge amount of turmoil in our marriage. This book is only possible because he helped me get through the hard times. I also want to give a mighty amount of credit to Althea, my therapist. She is the one who pushed me to write this book. Her wisdom was greatly appreciated. Acknowledgements. All scripture is from the New International Version, unless otherwise stated. Edited by Marjorie Emmert. Introduction. You will rejoice. Human bodies are puzzling. And mental illness plagues numerous people in the world today. Mental illness impacts the lives of at least 1 in 4 adults and 1 in 10 children, or 60 million Americans. NAMI.org. I see a gap, though. Most churches don't truly address the issue of mental disease. It's not that they must address every health problem. But Christians seem to go the opposite way and say that belief in God can solve a person's mental problems, including actual disorders. I believe that the church needs to express the difference between worldly grief and hardship and the concrete health issue of mental illness. People need to know it is okay to take medication, go to therapy, and work with medical doctors to treat their ailments, even their mental disorders. That doesn't mean that we should ignore the help of God. In Psalm 30, verse 2, David called to God for help, and he healed him. We need to call to God also, and he will heal us. In Psalm 107, verse 20, God sent forth his word and healed them. Therefore, let us give thanks to the Lord for his unfailing love and his wonderful deeds for men. Psalm 107. Verse 21. Jesus told his disciples that their grief would turn to joy. John chapter 16, verse 22. One of the definitions of grief is acute sorrow or intense emotional suffering. Sorrow isn't just ordinary, but acute, meaning it's sharp. I know that in my life, I would describe my mental pain as sharp. It is so comforting to know Jesus knows and understands. Jesus knew we would have deep sadness here on earth. How could we possibly escape it? We're not living in eternity yet with Jesus. As Christians, we long for the day we're with Jesus. We groan inwardly as we wait eagerly for our adoption as sons, the redemption of our bodies. Romans chapter 8, verse 23. Sometimes when having trouble mentally, it's hard not to groan or want to groan. I know I feel like groaning and sometimes actually do. That gives us an idea of what Paul means in this verse. It also helps us understand our pain in general. We are not really at home yet with God. It is like we are homesick. Grief will turn to joy or great pleasure. That joy is equal and opposite of the grief. It is acute and intense. Just think, the joy will be as intense as the sorrow and pain. Jesus said to them, "You will rejoice." The time will come to truly rejoice forever. Hopefully, you can also come to rejoice here on earth. True rejoicing can only come from our Father in heaven. Jesus endured many hardships here on earth because he loved us beyond belief. He also said in John chapter 16, verse 33, that he told us these things so that in him you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble, but take heart, I have overcome the world. Jesus wants his children to make it through life with a heart for him. That is the reason I am alive today. I wouldn't be here if I didn't know God was here for me. I would have committed suicide. I know it is the weak way out, but I didn't care when the pain was so intense. It was a sharp mental pain that wouldn't let up even briefly. And even knowing it would get better eventually, I still couldn't bear it. I really don't know how I made it. The only answer is Jesus. Jesus loves you and does understand what you are going through. It's hard to comprehend, but only he truly knows your brain and heart. I have been diagnosed with bipolar disorder and obsessive-compulsive disorder. I also have multiple sclerosis and narcolepsy. That doesn't necessarily mean I'll understand you if you have these, but it is to show you that I have a heart for those involved. My problem is unique to me, just as yours is unique to you. I have a bachelor's degree in biology with a minor in chemistry, so I am very interested in the physical and biological side of malfunctions of the body and brain. When it comes to nature versus nurture, I am mostly interested in the nature part at this point. Many books have been written to help people deal with the nurture part as well as the situational side. This book is looking at mental disease from the perspective of it being a health issue. I want to give comfort and aid to those suffering with deep emotional pain caused by mental illness. I want to open the world as God sees it. Just like if someone had cancer and needed support, I want to give support for the chronic illnesses that can be categorized as mental disorders. They are chronic illnesses just like any other chronic illness. At the end of every day's devotional, you'll find questions that will hopefully make you think. I recommend writing down the answers to solidify your thinking. Writing them down will put your thoughts and ideas into a concrete form, requiring true contemplation of the questions. Take this book and use it as you see fit. It is for you. My desire and prayer is that you may find hope and healing in these pages and the pages of the Bible. Whenever you have questions, go to the Bible. It really does have all the answers you need. Day 1. Delicate Machine. Our brains are works of art created by God. Illness transforms our bodies, including our brains. The brain is so complex that no one will ever discover everything about it. Diseases such as bipolar disorder and obsessive-compulsive disorder are difficult to understand. Each person's mental illness is unique. Indeed, no two people have the same ailment. Treating the so-called same affliction will usually require different treatments. Brains may contain similar mutations, but the rest of each person's brain is different. Also, a body is attached to the brain. Our bodies end up being exponentially varied. In other words, the differences between each person are endless. Not only are our brains different, but our other organs and bodily mechanisms are also different. It's no wonder that it is so hard to treat mental illness. Jonathan Miller said, "Illness is not something a person has. It's another way of being. Being sick is just the way we are." That sounds negative, but that allows us to appreciate our unique being. It's a part of who we are. We can't just completely get rid of our adversity, like dropping off a package. It resides in us. You can manage this inherent part of you. The word inherent means existing in someone as a natural and inseparable quality, as Webster's New World Dictionary defines it. We can't separate ourselves from our mental illness, but we can learn to deal with it. Our brain is so complex and wonderfully made that only God can help us. It can be done because all things are possible with God. Mark chapter 10, verse 27. Questions to ponder. 1. What do I know about my body? What is unique to me? 2. If your brain is a work of art, what does it look like? What kind of art is it? Day 2. Great Physician. In Psalm 30, verse 1, David exalts God as one who lifts him out of the depths, and God can do that for us also. Our distress at times is like the depths. We feel so low and deep, but God can and will bring us up from the grave. Psalm 30, verse 3. Being on the brink of death when thinking of suicide is one way of looking at the grave. He will spare you from going down into the pit. Psalm 30, verse 3, where there is no way out. God knows everything, including how your brain functions. Since no two people have the same exact illness, only God can fully help. Family and friends will be able to help a little, but it takes an omniscient God to bring healing and reconciliation. Your body is a delicate machine that needs fine-tuning. God is the technician who will be doing that fine-tuning. Let him do that. He loves you very much and wants to fix the emotional engine he has created so intricately. To supplement God's work, know yourself. After God, you know yourself the best. Trust yourself. I found that people will tell me different things, but deep down, I can tell what is indeed going on. Listen to your inner voice and pay attention. You are your best doctor here on earth. Be open and honest, and speak up at doctor's appointments. As the great physician and wonderful counselor, God can and will use physicians and therapists to help you. Constantly pray that God will work through the doctors and therapists. He will do that. Even if the professionals aren't Christians, God is able to utilize them. He will be in them using their earthly bodies to do His will. Please never stop praying that God's will be done. We are made in God's image. Our baseline of emotions and sensitivity is one that fits God's profile. It is in coming back to God and back to our origins that we truly find peace. As we begin to recover and head closer to what God wants us to be, we can remember that God is with us. He accepts us no matter what. He will always be everywhere, omnipresent, continually helping us. Our bodies and brains are full of more good than bad since we are made in God's image. Remember that even though we feel full of much negativity, the good will win out. If our bodies were balances, the side with the good would be all the way down, and the side with the bad would be all the way up, because there are truly more positive things in our lives than negative. The reason all of this is true is how God created us as human beings. He loved us so much that He made us in His image. Prayer before an appointment. Dear Father in heaven, You are the great physician and wonderful counselor. I praise You for who You are and what You do. I know You are here for me. You are omnipotent and omniscient. You know all things, including how my brain works, because You made it. Sin came into the world and brought decay so that my brain isn't working correctly. You already know that, but I would like Your will to be done today. Please come into my heart and brain and allow me to understand myself to the extent that I can help, doctor or therapist, to help me. Please work through, doctor or therapist.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.